Danville Boyle County Chamber of Commerce, and I'm here today at the Community Arts Center with Mary Beth Touchstone, the Executive Director. Hi, Mary Beth.
Hi.
Jenny Jacoby, the Marketing Director, and Brandon Long, the Program Director. And we're going to talk a little bit about some of the exciting things going on. And I'm going to start with Jenny. What's been going on lately?
Well, we just finished our annual Dantastic Race that Brandon is sporting the shirt for, sponsored by M&M Electric right here in town. And we had 15 different stops, with most of those 10 or more being various businesses actually throughout the county. And we had 16 teams of four participate, and it was a great success. Raised money for the Community Arts Center and allowed people to travel all over Danville, Boyle County and check out some of the local businesses that they may not normally go into.
And this is your second time doing this?
Yes.
And you're looking at doing it again?
We are. And we're actually looking at possibly throwing it to the spring and seeing what kind of response we can get with participants in the spring versus the fall, and hope to increase our team numbers next year.
Well, great. I've heard great things about it. Mary Beth, tell me about these events and how you are able to host them and sponsor them.
We're reaching out to the entire community and trying to offer opportunities to young and old, to all demographics. We have a program called Lunch with the Arts, and it's on the third Wednesday of every month. It's an hour-long program at noon, and it's designed so that people who live locally or who are working locally can just stop in. We'll have a box lunch for them if they order one, and they get to see a visual or performing artist either perform or lecture or demonstrate. And so that's a really nice program. I think you've talked with Brandon earlier about our outreach program called Arts Cart. Yeah, our outreach program called Arts Cart. And then another program that we've just recently introduced called Starry Night Studio. And that's a social painting experience. And I stress the social aspect of it.
So I don't need to be an artist to do this.
You do not have to be an artist.
I can come and just throw some paint on the canvas.
What you do is you come with your beverage, snacks of choice, your friends, and we provide everything else. We'll have an instructor, the apron, the paint, the canvas. Everything will be set up. And then the instructor will guide you through creating your own masterpiece. Your masterpiece is going to look different than the next person's masterpiece, but it's all the same masterpiece.
Great girls' night out opportunity.
It is. It's excellent. And we also are looking for sponsors for each of these events. Now, with Lunch with the Arts, Doug Little with Little Oil Company is our presenting sponsor. But there are occasions where we need sponsors for specific lecturers, mm-hmm. and that would be just a really wonderful opportunity for businesses to showcase. Starry Night Studio, we're looking for opportunities to maybe marry up with some of these newer businesses that are coming in, where folks can start at one of the bistros, have something to eat, have a little beverage with their friends, come down here, do a painting, and then follow up somewhere else in town. So it's a really nice natural link for the folks who are out for a little bit of entertainment in the evening.
So almost a progressive night.
Absolutely.
It sounds fun. What else are we doing in the programming area, Brandon?
We're pretty much gearing up for our big train exhibit that we've got coming up, which is going to be sort of our blockbuster exhibit that will be similar to our dinosaur exhibit that we did last year.
And that was a huge success.
It was huge. I don't know if anything can ever be that huge, but we're going to try with this train exhibit. We're kind of focusing on the railroad and all of the aspects that goes into, the culture in America revolves around the railroad.
And actual railroad setups with model trains and stuff that will be here for people to look at, or are we looking at the art side of this?
We're going to have, we're planning on having the photographs of O. Winston Link. He's mm-hmm. a really fabulous photographer that kind of captured the last era of the steam railroad. And that's going to be a really great show coming out of the Link Museum in Roanoke, Virginia. Oh. So they have a traveling exhibit with that. We're also planning on having some model railroad things and also some really fun activities that we're going to be putting together for the kids.
So a lot of hands-on interactive opportunities
yeah.
for children.
Yeah.
And a lot of your programming, I know you do all of these things, but you always try to build a child component in it, because where better to start with the arts than with children?
Absolutely.
And sometimes it's our children that teach the adults mm-hmm. things that they should know about the arts. So, is the facility for rent if some group might need a meeting or, maybe a special event type of thing?
This is a great place to have a meeting. We've hosted weddings, we've hosted receptions, rehearsal dinner parties. training sessions for organizations, just meeting space. The Grand Hall is wonderful for that purpose, but we also have two rooms upstairs, the Farmers Bank Gallery and then Studio One. Both of those rooms are available for rent as well for smaller groups. Mm-hmm. We often have our board of directors meetings up here. Mm-hmm. So yes, it's all available for rent. And even the Garden Club has come in and actually taken over all three floors and used it to showcase their activities. Wonderful. And that was wildly successful.
So they just need to call the Community Arts Center and ask for specifics, and you work with them based on what they need.
Yes, that's exactly right.
We also have the Arts on Main gift shop located right in the front of the Community Arts Center. And after the dinosaur exhibit, we reopened as a new gift shop, and it has lots of things perfect for unique kind of gifts. We just got in bottle cap earrings and some very unique pottery pieces, as well as chocolates, lotions, soaps, and jewelry, and also books and toys for kids. So it's kind of an all-around spot where you can find a lot of little things that are in your price budget that, you know, you can give as a gift and not have to go to Walmart and get the generic toy every time.
Wonderful.
And right after Thanksgiving, we're going to be reopening again with All About Trains. So if you have a train enthusiast in your family, this is the place to come.
So you'll have new items in here that will reflect around the train exhibit.
Absolutely.
That's
starting
wonderful.
The day after Thanksgiving and going all the way through the end of February.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
So you do gear some of your exhibits and the gift shop to mm-hmm. what's here on exhibit. I know the dinosaurs, you did that, and they have
sure.
a lot of
sure.
interesting things for kids to buy and take home to remember the big dinosaurs they saw. That's good to know.
Yeah.
Thank you. Well, I really thank you all for your time, Mary Beth, Jenny, Brandon. It's been very enlightening, and I'm really encouraging our community to come in and take a look if they haven't been here. I hope they've been here to any of the exhibits. I've come to the school exhibits, and it's just a wonderful opportunity for our community and beyond, because you draw regionally from a lot of counties. So I'm going to encourage a lot of people to stop in and see all of you.
Well, we appreciate that. Thank you so much.